Hi everybody, Llewellyn here with Warren to Whimsy today, and I am going live on the Redesign with Prima page. I'm just going to wait a second here and see if I see anybody pop on and make sure that I'm in the right place and that it's all working. This is the first time I've gone live as my business page instead of my name, so I just want to make sure that I'm able to see comments and that you guys can see me. There's a few of you. Okay, so I'll just say hi again. I'm Llewellyn, and I am the owner and creator at Worn to Whimsy. And today, I'm gonna be working on this little dresser that I have behind me, and I'm just gonna be adding a transfer to the front. And then also, if I have time, I wanted to work with some of the stick and style stencils and use those with some wax on the sides of the drawers just to spruce those up as well. So the transfer that I'm going to be using today is On a Voyage, and it is the sailboat transfer. And I have been waiting around for a piece for this for a while. So as you hop on, just say hello. I want to make sure that I can see the comments and make sure that you guys can hear me okay and everything. So just say hi and tell me where you're from. Let me refresh my computer page as well. See if I'm missing something, because I'm not seeing anything yet, so we'll give it a couple minutes. Ah, there we go. Okay, so I'm not seeing any comments on there either anyways. All right, so this is the transfer I'm going to use today, the On a Voyage one, and I'm just going to be applying it to the front of this little thing right here. So what I've done so far is I've already done, I primed it because I was a bit worried about bleed through. Oh, hello everybody, I can see you now. Hi Terry. Hi Nick. Okay, so I've already done a base coat. I use Dixie Belle paint primarily, and I think to match the transfer, what colors did I grab? I grabbed Cobalt and the Gulf, and then I just kind of did blending in with some cotton white. And I just pulled the colors from a part of the transfer. So that's normally what I do on the rest of the piece. If it's one of these like picture transfers, it's helpful to just pick a couple of colors and go with it. So to begin with, I've left the front white because I don't want the color on the background to show through my transfer. Sorry, I'm looking for a little stick. There we go. I don't want the color from the background to show through the transfer at all, and I didn't want it to dull it down, so I stayed with white for this piece this time. Make sure you guys can see, okay? Hello, Shaz. Good to see you on here. And to begin with, I took my drawers out. So I took the drawers out and I lined them up on the floor. I know I've seen a few other people do that to kind of figure out where to put the transfer. So I took the drawers out, I lined them up all in a row, and I laid the transfer out on them like as neat as I could. And then I just kind of folded it around the edge and made a mark. And then I just, I cut off the edges already for the sake of time with an X-Acto knife. So with this one, I got really lucky. My transfer basically fits perfectly on the middle drawer. I'm starting from the middle and then going upwards and outwards. So we're just gonna start with this one. This one's a little bit different than the flowers because it is a whole picture. There's no little spaces to mess up, but because it's a whole one giant piece, you wanna get it placed exactly right. Because if it's just a little bit off, it's going to show. Okay, so I'm just going to line it up. And I had already measured and made sure that I knew exactly where it was going to fit. And start in the middle and go out. Now, I left a little bit of overlap on the edges. I can go in with the X-Acto knife and cut that off, And right now I'm just pretty much placing it. I'm not rubbing it on yet. Just kind of sticking it down so I know exactly where I want my transfer to be. Really gently here. So here's where the knife comes in. And I'm gonna cut the part between the drawer, where the drawer stops on the top. And I'm just gonna stick my knife in there and try it and do it as straight and as clean as I can. That way, if my drawer moves at all while I'm rubbing it, I won't get any tearing or lifting. Go in the corner here so I can take this little edge off. I cut my transfer just a little bit large, so I had a tiny bit of leeway. And then when you're done with this kind of style of transfer, you can go along the edge and just sand really lightly to get any extras off that you didn't need or want there. Cut along the bottom of the drawer. And the drawer slightly, this is an older little tiny dresser, so the drawer goes in ever so slightly. And that's why I really wanted to cut the transfer before I pushed the drawer all the way back in there. Okay, and now I'm just gonna rub it on there. So I found with these bigger ones, I actually had a pretty easy time getting the transfer on. That part didn't bother me at all. It was really the placement and the cutting and making sure it was all lined up was key. And in prep for this, I painted it in white. I primed it and then I painted it one coat of white. And I usually prime and, oh, hi guys, there you all are on there. I'm gonna have to go back and look at all the comments and make sure I can answer anything. So yes, I painted it yesterday, and then I made sure that I would have a good 24 hours between letting the paint dry and putting the transfer on. And that's usually what I go with. They also say, you know, I think they say 48 hours just to be cautious. And that makes sense, you know, because in some areas you're going to have more humidity and that might mess with your transfer a bit. I know that if I let my paint dry out in the garage, I might have more of a problem with the transfer adhering. It will just be harder to rub it on there. And as opposed to me letting my paint dry inside, and then I have a much easier time. So I took this one in yesterday and let it dry inside in my home. Okay, so you can see, I just peeled up a corner just to make sure that the transfer was on there. And this one just, it really does, because it's one large piece, it comes off really easily. And it went up over this drawer just the tiniest bit. So I'm just gonna rub my, or take my X-Acto knife and go along the line. Got a little bit caught right there. That's okay. I can always sand around the edge a bit too. This piece, I wanted to use one of the new transfers, but this piece is a bit more rustic and it called to me, this transfer did. I've been wanting to use it for a while. Let me make sure. Hi, Joe. Hi, Roz. Hello, everybody. Hi, Jan. Okay. We'll just keep going. I'm gonna rub the middle on. And please let me know if you have any questions. I'll keep looking back to make sure I can answer them. Rubbed on here. And once I get this transfer on, I've done my base coat on the rest of the piece, but it wasn't my final coat. So I'll be going back and I'll make sure that my colors match really well, and it just kind of flows with the rest of the piece. So far I just kind of did some rough blending in there. I didn't really do anything super technical. I've seen other people paint around the edges of the transfer, which I think is really beautiful. Kind of make it a part of the piece and continue the painting off the edge and continue the style of painting that they have on the transfer all the way around the piece. So who knows? Maybe I'll go with that. Okay, so I think I've got this on pretty good. Check on the corner here. That drawer kind of slid in, so see if I can even get it. Get an edge. Come on, little edges. Well, it's sticking, but I can't reach my transfer edge because my drawer went in. Let me pull out the bottom drawer here. Now I'll be able to get the edge. I cut it so close I couldn't get any of the plastic to peel it away. Okay, we lift the plastic and just slowly peel it off. And I like to go slow because then if I have any issues, I can put the transfer back down and continue to rub it on if there's any tearing. And there we go. The middle part is nearly done. And yes, I do use, I use polycrylic a lot over the tops of the transfers. And I kind of just go along and burnish it with my fingers. I want to make sure there's no bubbles, or if you feel a little wrinkle, you just don't want any air under there, is all you're really doing, is getting rid of any air pockets that have been left underneath. What can happen with the air pockets is when you do go to seal it, it can kind of get under there and it can pull it away from your piece. And I'm just gonna, there's some little tiny edges which I can sand off later, or I can just roll them under the edge. And you see how quick and easy that is? I mean, we've got a good portion of this transfer done already. There went my drawer. I think I might have to fix that with the drawers too. Put some little stoppers in there and make sure they don't keep going back. And just peel it away. So fast and easy. Okay, so that's one of the reasons that I love transfers, is because I do a lot of hand-painted pieces. So for me, the transfers kind of give me a break and let me have fun with the rest of the piece. I see people are answering for me. Okay, just gonna keep going as we move up or down. Maybe I'll do the bottom first here. And the same with these. I cut them out width-wise, but I didn't do the height, just to kind of give you guys an idea of how I would do that. So I'm gonna put this little drawer back in. It does look nice, Sherry, doesn't it? And I need to wax these drawers too eventually. I like to use a wax or some sort of oil on the drawer runners to make them slide better. Okay, so I'm gonna get it stuck. I'm gonna stick it down when all else fails, just beat the door in. I'm going to stick it down first to line it up and make sure that everything lines up properly with the sailboat. There we go. It's got to be the hardest part for me. Okay, I'm going to hold it in the center. There we go. Pull this drawer out a little. Here we go. Now, I will be going down a little bit on the piece, but I might just, another way that you can do the transfer is to pull the drawer out. So now that I have it all lined up, I think I'll just pull the drawer out. That looks easier for now. And I'm always changing things up. I just kind of do whatever works at the moment. Whatever works best. I really don't want this to go on sideways. I might have a tiny ripple. Nope, it smoothed out. Can you guys still see okay? There we go. And thank you, Ross, for answering all the questions. So I'm going to get it rubbed on here a little bit. Go from one side to the other. Or you can start in the center and go from one end or to one side and then to the other. And now that it's rubbed down over there, you can go in, if you're going right along the edge, and just cut off the trim. Keep moving. See it starting to bubble up and pull away from the plastic, and that just means I'm getting it on there really well. Okay, now I'm going to cut across the edges. And I'm going to take the bottom off as well. I'm just going to save it for the bottom piece of trim. Make sure I don't get my little knife stuck on it. There we go. And I'm going to save this piece for the little bottom piece of trim you see down at the bottom of the dresser right here. And cut this side nice and even. And it should be ready to lift away. I know, I love this transfer. It's super cute. Hi, Paula. And hi, Martha. Good to see you guys all on here. Thank you for joining me today. Okay. Make sure there's no lifting. And slowly, slowly go along. Looks good. So right here, I didn't line it up perfectly. So there's a little tiny bubbles I can see. So I'm just going to go through and make sure I've rubbed it all down really well. It's not really making much of a difference in the way it looks. You can use a clean cloth and rub it down if you feel that you have more of an adhesion issue, or you can use like a sanding sponge. And I'll just use my sleeves. That looks good. All right, let's put this in. And I gotta remember to do the bottom piece of trim too. I might save that for after this. There we go. Yes, it's looking good. I love this one. So, as I said before, I will definitely be going back in and painting the sides and cleaning everything up and making it match as best as I can with the colors. There's so many colors in this transfer, though, I wasn't super worried about which ones I chose. I just chose ones, whatever I felt like that matched well. I also tend to kind of wait to use my transfers. I try and find the right piece. Yeah, you're going to want something that the transfer fits well and the style of it kind of suits the piece. So I'm kind of picky about my pieces. And that looks like it'll line up right there. So I'm going to go ahead for this one. I'm going to cut along the bottom of the transfer so that I can see right where the color on it ends. And I'm just cutting in a straight line. I am cutting off the little bit of a halo. I don't need to, because it's going to go underneath the bottom of that drawer. It's just the way that the transfer lined up for me. But I'm going to cut off the halo so that I can see. And then I might trim the top off really quick before I take off the backing, so that I don't have so much transfer left to deal with. And I just want to make sure that I have this lined up on the sail here. That's kind of my goings. Like, it's telling me where it's at. So I'm going to make a little mark right here. And you can even take, like, I've taken a pencil and just lifted the transfer slightly and just made a little tiny mark on the piece where it went, because I'm going to be pulling the drawer out with this one too. I don't know if I have a pencil handy. No, I'll find the paint with my pencils. So I'll just make some little lines on the side, and that's going to be where my transfer is going to go to. This drawer out here. Yes, you can put the plastic back over to rub it on if you need to. Okay, so my little fold marks are still here, and they're just kind of showing me where I'm going to be placing the transfer. So let me pull, and they'll still be on that top plastic. Otherwise, I would have used, if I'd had a pencil available, I would have just used a tiny bit of pencil or something, or made a mark right where that top of the sail was going to be going. Okay, think I've got it. Start from the middle and go out. And then I'll get it rubbed on here. Now, once your transfer's on there, you're pretty much ready to go. There's not really any waiting time for sealing or painting. So if you wanted to, you could go right in with your paint colors and just sort of blend it into the transfer. I think I'm just gonna leave this one looking like a painting on the front of the piece. On really well here. And right on those edges too, because then I can go back and just cut along that line right along the edge. If I can find my X-Acto knife. Where have I gone and put it? I had it right here. There it is. It's almost sitting on it. Hi, Michelle. Good to see you. Thanks for joining today. Okay, so I'm just going to cut in here. I don't know if you can see it. There we go. I'm just going to cut in here again, right along the edge of the drawer. And it makes for a really nice clean edge. You know, sometimes the drawers that we have aren't super even, so this makes it so that you get the perfect size pulling the drawers out like this. And then lift your transfer up away. How much time do I have left? Roz, do you have a time for me? Lift off the plastic and then just rub it down. This one, I got it on there really even and really well, so I don't have to worry about any bubbling. You can also kind of look at it sideways and you can usually see, you'll see little mini bubbles. And that's why some people really like to burnish it with the sanding pad. I have done that before. Okay, let me lift this one back up in. You don't need that. Okay, little dresser. This drawer has been giving me trouble. I think I have it uneven. Hang on, guys. Oh, it is uneven. I can see it from up here. There we go. Okay. The X-Acto knife. I can't even remember. I think I found mine at the Dollar Tree. A couple of minutes if I'm doing 30 minutes. Okay, well, pretty much done everything I set out to do. I love this transfer. It lined up great. I got my little in-betweens. I'm just gonna go back and paint around it. I was also gonna show the stick and style stencils, so I think I might, if I'm okay to continue for a few minutes, I think I'm just gonna throw the stick and style stencil on there. I have it all ready to go, so. Okay, so what I went with for the stick and style, let me show it to you. I'm gonna be using Modern Arrows. And they just come in a roll. So when you roll it out, I can go as long as I want. I could paint all day. Better be careful what you ask for. So when I roll it out, it just looks like this. And it's basically like a sticker. So it's sticky on the back. And then you can take it and you just press it, line it up and press it on wherever you want. Thank you. so you can see right here. And for my wax, grab that. I'm going to be using Old Denim from Art Alchemy, and I wanted to use a navy color to match the transfer, like this little blue over here. And you can see it. It's got a bit of a shine to it. It's really pretty. And then I'm just going to use this little wax brush right here. And once this transfer is stuck on there, it's really on there. They stick really well. And you can see I've already used this transfer for a couple of the drawers. And then you just start rubbing the wax on. You don't need too much. Actually, I mean, I have used one tiny little pot of wax for many, many projects. So you don't need too much with this one. And it doesn't go under the stencil because the stencil is stuck down. And you just keep rubbing it in and you make sure you get it in all the little corners and all the little spaces. I do like using a wax on my drawers because it doesn't add that, especially like these, you could see that these didn't have all that much room on the edges. So I decided with a wax because I didn't want any more paint to be in this to kind of fog it up, you know. Yeah, I love this color. The denim color is really pretty. And it looks really good with this transfer. And I love using the stick and style for the sides of my drawers. It's almost the perfect width for all my drawers. I either use it, you know, once across, usually fits, or if it's a wider drawer, I'll use it twice. It's just simple and straightforward, so gives the inside that extra bling. Okay, that's it for my wax. And I did miss a little spot back here, but there's a knot hole. So it's because of this funny little dresser. And then you just pull it up. And you can reuse your stick and style stencil. I've used them up to 20 times before. So I'm just going to tape that. Sorry, guys. I'm going to tape that on my cart here really quick. So if you just, I just tape it to my metal paint cart that I have. And voila! The drawers look so good. Hi, Kimberly. Thank you. Thanks for popping on. And this also, this dries pretty quick. I would leave it for a few minutes before I tried to turn it over and do the other one so I don't get it. So I don't get it on the floor. And Roz told me I have time, so I'm gonna go and I'm gonna do one more because they're fine. And all I did to the sides of these drawers was I whitewashed them with part paint, part water, and then let that dry really well. So I'll use the same stencil. Make sure it's facing the same way. Get on there. He's cute. Thanks. And I'm a lot of my stuff goes to a beach shop, so this transfer is going to be perfect. Okay. And you saw how easy that was. I mean, you can just stick it on there, even if you've already used it. It still sticks very nicely. And then just rub that wax right in. And if you want to, you can go for a distressed look. I've done that where I did the wax. You know, I did the wax kind of like what I have back here, lighter. Then it wouldn't be so thick and so dark. see, we get this one little row and then we'll be all finished for today. Yes, Terry, they're very user friendly. I think they're, yeah, one of the easier products that I use for sure. They just make it so simple. And my kids like them too, so I have to hide them. You got some wax, Kimberly? Awesome. Oh yeah, I saw your post. It looks like you got quite a few goodies. Okay, and then just peel it back. And the stencil is ready to go. Okay, and that's all that I have today. I'm gonna turn this back up so you can see me. Thanks for joining me today, and yeah, I hope you guys have a great rest of the week, and I will see you again soon. Bye.